Good morning, good evening, good afternoon to all the viewers around the world. This is Desmos, and welcome to my page, welcome to the channel. This is the channel where we break apart free from narcissistic abuse. So if you're here, you're not here by coincidence. You're on the right page and you're looking for answers. So on this page, I do my best to give you the answers you're looking for. Now, after waking up from abuse, I realized that there is millions of people around, because I used to think actually it was like, in my opinion, I was the only one. But after waking up, then I realized that actually there are millions of people around the world who have been subjected to narcissistic abuse. And my question has always been one, ever since waking up. I've always asked myself one question in particular, is that as much as this abuse is real and is existing around families and friends, even partnerships, why is it that actually less people are very much aware about this? Why is it that less people are aware about narcissism, and yet narcissism is existing all over the world? Because the playbook is the same. It does not matter if somebody is from India, China, or US, or Egypt. The narcissists, when you meet them, they are reading from the same playbook. But the question has always been in my mind, and I'm very sure on many people's minds around the world, why is narcissism addressed, fully addressed? Why aren't the people getting the information they need? Why aren't people aware about narcissism? Why does somebody has got, first of all, to face narcissism before they become aware about what is narcissism? Why aren't the people told before that there are also other people called narcissists? Why do the people have to first face or even go through narcissistic abuse, and even finally waking up, and then even taking time to heal? And even if they know that, what is even making it worse is that the narcissists, they are getting away with it. A narcissist will abuse somebody and leave somebody for the dead and move on to the next partner, and they always get away with it. And the courts of law, they're not fully tackling and even giving the proper justice needed for the individuals who have suffered narcissistic abuse, and the narcissists are usually getting away with it. The question has always been why. So why aren't the people getting the proper justice they need, number one? And secondly, why isn't the world and the masses aware of narcissism even before they get into it? Why are they not aware that there are individuals with such a disorder that is able to destroy somebody emotionally and physically without their consent even? So if you have something you want to say about that, let me hear in the comment section below, because that has been my opinion, my personal opinion, and my personal thought, what I had in my mind after waking up. But well, the question for today is going to be about brain fog. Now, the brain fog experience, if you've been in a narcissistic relationship, you've definitely come to that place where you believe that actually you're losing your memory. So if you've been that individual who has been in a relationship with a narcissist, there have been those cases whereby you've seen actually this looks like you forgot to pay a certain bill yesterday, or even sometimes there was a bill that popped in the house, was posted to the house, and you forgot to pay the bill. And not one only, even two or three, a lot of bills, you've forgotten to pay your bills on time. Also, sometimes you find that you've forgotten the very mere simple basic things that you've even done yesterday with your partner. You've actually even forgotten some of those things. So it's like you reach that extent where you feel like actually all of a sudden, eventually, you're losing your memory. And what's happened behind the scenes, if you see narcissists, they are... like I've always said in my videos, narcissists, they are broken souls. I want to say it very straightforward, and I'm not sugarcoating it. Narcissists, they are broken souls, and they are empty vessels. So if you're living with somebody who is an empty vessel, or who is a broken soul for that matter, that means that actually you're living with a very, very unhealthy individual. You know what I mean? So when you're living with a narcissist, they are introducing their own playbook to your life. They are introducing their own style, their own personality, and their own playbook. And of course, you're not going to know what you're dealing with. in the beginning. So you're going to start reading or even learning a few things from them, and now starting to identify with their own personality, which is good, which is not going to be, it may be questionable in the beginning, because when you start to see a narcissist doing one or two or three things, you're going to start having questions. And you start to think that something is, there is something, you know, it's, there are some holes that are not properly filled up. You're going to start having a few questions, one or two or three questions on a daily basis. But somewhere down the road, you're going to realize that actually when you're living with a narcissist, you're going to start normalizing their personality. So you're going to believe that, okay, so maybe this is just something, this is another, you're going to start believing that this is another type of action or some sort of a personality that you just that you thought existed but you just didn't know about. Now you're going to start follow the narcissistic playbook. If you've been with these individuals for years, they have been feeding you with their style each and every single day, just because it's just that you just didn't see it, or you just didn't even know about it, but they have been feeding you every day, daily basis, with their own personality. But not only just because for you, only thing you didn't know is that they were feeding you with a disordered personality, because they're already disordered. So if you are following somebody and doing things according to the, you know, living according to their means, according to their lifestyle, and you didn't know that person was disordered, so definitely you're now starting to look like them. But you see, at the end of the day, this is not the only problem, because the more a person abuses you, when those people, those individuals trauma bond you eventually and start abusing you during a partnership, you're going to reach that point where you feel like you're starting to lose your memory to some point. At some extent, you're starting to lose your memory. It's like you're forgetting things all of a sudden. You're forgetting the bills. You're forgetting to pay the bills on time. You're forgetting sometimes. You're forgetting the things you've said. You know what I mean? And even sometimes you're trying to make a conversation, but then you feel as if it looks as if you're forgetting the proper words to use even in the conversation. You know what I mean? So it's like there's a brain fog going on in your head. It took me a while actually to understand why I was losing my memory. It would not make sense to me, because I remember in that moment, in those days, I used to wonder, why was I forgetting things all of a sudden? It's like somewhere deep into the partnership, you start to forget a lot of things which actually very, very important things which actually even matter. Hospital appointments, you know, paying the bills. Some of the conversations, the things just the mere simple things you did yesterday or even an hour ago, you cannot remember the things you've done even sometime 5 minutes ago. You know what I mean? So, in my opinion, I believe that a lot of narcissistic victims, they have, are victims of abuse. They have also somehow experienced brain fog. So, if the abuse gets intense, the biggest reason why many people have to go through very long sessions of therapy is because actually one of the number one reasons, you may have heard me in my videos talking about forgetting the person he was in the first place. That is because your brain, you have been brainwashed to that extent whereby you've already even forgotten the person he was. If a person can come in front of you and explain to you that they have forgotten, or even confirm to you that they have forgotten the people they were before they met the narcissist, that means that person has been intensively abused. And it means also that person has also gone through very long cycles of depression, because through abuse, of course, from abuse comes depression eventually. If a person is abusing you on a daily basis, they put you through long sessions or long periods of depression. And usually memory loss as well can come as a result of depression, the depression that the narcissist has put you through. So, in this video, you may be that victim. Maybe you don't know yet who you'll be. Because in my video, I've always told you it's about enlightenment. So if you're that individual who is in that kind of relationship, and for some reason you feel you're starting to forget the basic things in life, you're forgetting the proper words to say, you have a problem, you have problems even solving the simplest things. It does not matter, again, I've always said, whether that partnership is your mother, your friend, your brother, even your workplace. You cannot forget. You cannot even, you have trouble. You almost feel like you have trouble even solving the simplest basic, you cannot solve the simplest problems you seem to have. You cannot solve them. It feels like as if you're losing words. It's like you're stammering all the time. You're losing words. You feel as if your language has changed. Your dialect has changed. Your language has changed. Your grammar is all of a sudden changing. There are all sorts of memory problems. You've done something 5 minutes ago. You cannot remember what you've done then. It is a very big sign that you're under depression, and it's a very big sign as well that you could be dealing with a narcissist at home. And that narcissist is very slowly, eventually, step by step, is eating away your brain and is actually putting you through very long series of depression. And it is the very case, it is the very reason why actually you're having that kind of memory loss and you're experiencing. It's called a brain fog. I call it a brain fog because it's like your brain, you feel as if your brain stops to function the way it used to. It's like you used to, now you stop to reason the way you used to before you met those individuals. Now you're reasoning in a certain kind of a way, you know what I mean? You feel as if your life or your life has eventually turned to face a certain direction, and a direction actually which is not even familiar to you. Very strange and even scary and not familiar to you. If you feel yourself, if you find that, if you're that individual who finds yourself that you feel your brain, your mind is taking you in a different direction, the direction that you're not used to in the first place, and which actually feels very scary to you, and also at the same time, you feel as if you're now starting to suffer very deep memory loss. You're starting to forget things all of a sudden. You're forgetting to pay your bills on time. You're forgetting the person you was before you met those individuals. Or sometimes you're forgetting even, sometimes you cannot even calculate the simplest of the numbers. You cannot even calculate the simplest solving. You cannot solve a problem, something you used to do before. A problem used to solve very easily before, you cannot solve that problem at the moment when you're with these individuals. And also sometimes you find yourself you're losing focus. It's like you do not have focus. All of a sudden you do not have focus of the things you're supposed to do. It's like your mind is all over the place. You want to do this, you want to do that, that's why in my videos as well, I've given you a real case scenario recently where you've reached that extent where you feel you do not love somebody, but then you love them at the same time. So it's like you're in the middle whereby you feel you love somebody, then you hate them at the same time. So that means that you've already now lost focus. It's like you no longer know if you're supposed to stay in love with somebody or if you're supposed to hate somebody at the same time. So now you're in the middle. You've heard me mention in that moment whereby if you've been a victim of abuse, you've reached that extent whereby you've forgotten what love feels like because you're no longer able to show love. It's like you've just normalized a situation whereby it's like, for example, you've created some kind of a survival mechanism, something what you think, okay, so that's the way the person behaves. This is the way I'm going to do. So you're creating, instead of loving somebody genuinely, you're now starting to create survival mechanisms because you believe that the person you're with is almost unbearable to stay with or even to live with. Now you started to create mechanisms you're going to use, survival methods you're going to use to stay with that person. It is a sign that you're dealing with a narcissist. It is a sign that you're dealing with abuse. The person you're with is abusing you, but they have intoxicated you deep enough, definitely, because you've reached that extent whereby you cannot live. Eventually, why? Because you've been trauma bonded. So if you're that kind of person who is suffering memory loss and you're experiencing all this kind of brain fog, it's like your brain cannot reason properly. You do not know if you need to leave the relationship, if you need to stay. You cannot focus on even the simple basic things you used to do. You have got all sorts of troubles solving the easiest problems, things you knew that you've solved before. Now you've reached that extent whereby you cannot solve those problems anymore. You're figuring out words every day. Sometimes you're talking 1,000 words per minute, or sometimes even not talking at all. It's like your speech pattern has also changed all of a sudden. It's very likely that you're dealing with a narcissist. This is a page of enlightenment, and if it gets to you, this message gets to you, you may want to think about your options. And until then, guys, It's been the video for today. It was all about brain fog and memory loss. If you're that end of the video, let me know in the comments below. Let me know where you are in this situation. Or if you've been there, you've had that kind of relationship, narcissistic relationship before, and you've had cases whereby you've also suffered some sort of memory loss or even some kind of a brain fog, let me know in the comments below as well what was your situation. And let's hear your story. Let's hear your side of the story, what you went through. Let's share together. It's always through sharing that people get information they need. Until then, guys, I love you all, and I'll get back to you in my next video. It's Narcissistic signing out. Much love and blessings.